Hey Robot Makers, I'm going to show you how to build your own BurgerBot. First of all, we're going to solder the Pico Lipo Shim to the Pico. Just going to add some flux just to make the soldering a little bit easier. And the soldering iron is now up to temperature. I've really got the wrong kind of nib on this soldering iron at the moment, and that's why I'm kind of doing it at a funny angle. It's a bit too bulky. Also notice that the red cable there is soldered to the 5 volt on the Pico. Also notice on this part the captive nuts, and this is where we put the battery in. This is actually the part that we just showed you on the other clip where I soldered the Pico to the Pico Lipo Shim. So we're just going to screw this on. The reason I mentioned that is because when I very first did this, I screwed all four screws down. This is what I'm saying, only screw the left hand side. Because if you screw these in and then you put the lipo shim on top, which is the next step, you've actually put that underneath and you'll never be able to get that off once you've soldered it in place. Ask me how I know. So notice the orientation there. There's a little diagram on the back of the Pico shim. You just need to match them up. We're just connecting the battery from the other side. You can see that when I press the button, we don't always get a very strong light on there, and that's because the connections are not very good. And even with pushing this down, the motor shim on top, we still don't get a very good connection. So in the end, I solder these in place. It's a nice little package. We're now going to screw this into the base. I've put some screws in already so it's easier to locate, and you'll see there there's the little captive nuts on the top and bottom, and the screws just screw into them, and it makes a really secure connection. Now I'm going to add the motors. These are the Pimroni motors, and they have the little connector already soldered onto the back, and it's a simple 2-pin connector. These are the motor holders, and the motors simply just push into them, and there's one for the other side as well. And then these are just going to screw into place. But first we need to add the little nuts, and then just use some pliers to squish them into place. Very satisfying. Yep, they don't fall out. And then we're simply just going to screw these in place with another couple of M3 bolts. If you need to, you can use a tap to create a thread. I do this and it really makes the screws easier to go in. It has a little ratchet on it, so you just need to flip the ratchet and it's very easy to come out. Add the rest of the screws in there. Next we're going to add the rangefinder. Again, this has got the captive nuts in place, so it makes it really easy to screw into place. I've gone for a two-tone colour scheme on this one, yellow and blue. This is the SparkFun quick distance sensor. It's an ultrasonic sensor, and it, unlike the regular ones, it actually has some quick connectors. This will make it a lot easier to wire up in the future. And there's actually a quick connector on the motor shim. Just need to add the quick cable, so that pushes into one of the two connectors on that side, doesn't matter which one, and then the other one just plugs into the, I keep calling it a motor shim, it's a motor pack, and then just push that into place. Not sure what that discoloration is on top of the rangefinder there. I think it's just something from the printer bed. And we're gonna add the thin moon buggy wheels. These are very easy to put on, and our robot's really coming to shape now. We're going to add the servo holder next. Again, this has got some captive nuts, makes it very easy to put into place and very secure. It's also very much quicker to print. These are two pieces, as you can see from the colour. So we're going to add the pen holder. Notice that little hole there. That's so that we can add an extra screw in there just to screw against the pen if the pen's a little bit slack. So we're going to add the servo. This is just an SG90 servo. Two little screws into there. I think these are M2 screws this time, and then we're going to put the pen holder in place and the little cog that goes against it. It's like a little rack and pinion mechanism. Just going to test fit the Sharpie and see if that fits okay. It's nice and snug. If we need to, we can add that screw at this point. I don't need it in this case. And then I'm just going to test it to see, yep, that looks good. Now I'm going to add the motor cables. I realised after doing this, I should really have done this before I screwed all the motor holders in place. So I just quickly undid them and then put them back in place. Again, it's easier if you unplug that motor pack and then push it all back into place. There we go. Just need to move that wire just so it doesn't catch on any of the wheels. The final step is just to crimp some female to male DuPont cables, and this is going to connect our servo up to the pins on the back of the Pico. Just using some nice wire strippers there, and I'm going to crimp them my own. I found that if you get a good crimping tool, it can make all the difference between a poor connection and a really great connection. So I'm just pushing them on there. And the red 5 volt cable is soldered to the 5 volt pin on the back of the Pico motor shim, motor pack. And the orange one is going to GPIO 16, and that just pushes on with a DuPont cable. And here we are, this is the finished article running some code. Hope you enjoyed this, I shall see you next time.